railway signaling system stands out as a technological marvel in the vast landscape of railway transportation. There are various types of signals are utilized in the railway network. For example, home signals are located near the station area to receive trains, along with starter signals, calling signals, automatic signals, and many more. In this exploration, we delve into the automatic signal, explaining its structure and demystifying its operations. The automatic signal, which is also commonly known as the automatic block signaling system. This sophisticated signaling system relies on technology to autonomously regulate and control train movements, contributing to the safety and efficiency of railway operations. These signals are activated automatically as trains enter, pass through, and exit the automatic signaling sections. This signaling system operates based on the block and interlocking systems. The blocks are interconnected with the junction station control room, displaying real-time information on train location and signal status. This is an illustration of a railway block where the track section is divided into insulated parts, or joints. Each of these block distances is standardized to be 120 meters, allowing only one train to occupy a block at a time. The interlocking system coordinates signals and switches to avoid conflicting movements. It ensures that signals and switches work in harmony, preventing unsafe conditions and guiding trains through the network in a controlled manner. The automatic signaling system works between two consecutive automatic stop signals, typically when the distance between automatic signals is equal to or greater than the braking distance. Three aspect signals suffice. However, if the distance is less than the braking distance, four aspect signals are necessary. In such cases, the sequence of aspects includes red, yellow, double yellow, and green. How can we identify an automatic block signal? It is simple. Just look for the distinctive black marker against a white background. Let's delve into a scenario to understand how the automatic signal operates. In this scenario, observe the signals, axle counters, and the interlocking system. The axle counter evaluator boxes are connected to both signals and axle counters, creating an interconnected network. When a driver identifies marker A on the signal, signifying it's an automatic signal, if the route or track is clear, all signals show a green color. As a train approaches and passes the signal, the axle counter detects the axles and transmits data to the evaluator box. Subsequently, the evaluator box sends a signal to change the color. Following this process, the signal transitions to red. Likewise, as the train proceeds and crosses the next signal, that signal changes to red, and the previous signal transitions to yellow. When this train crosses the third signal, it turns red, and automatically the preceding signals shift to yellow. Other previous signals shift to double yellow. All these automatic changes are orchestrated by the seamless collaboration of sensors and track circuits. If you're eager to delve deeper into the world of sensors, share your thoughts in the comments. Everyone, join the conversation and hit the bell icon, as I'm always at your doorstep, ready to guide you through the fascinating realm of railway technology. Thank you. Let's grow up, never stop learning.